Blues musician Keb Mo has been a star for decades, but you might be surprised to learn how long it took to get there. NewsHour Weekend special correspondent Tom Casciato recently had a career-spanning conversation with the 70-year-old singer-songwriter who just released a new album called Good to Be.
It's like tuning up a car, you gotta get everything ready. Woke up this morning, wrong side of the bed. If I haven't that night, feeling it in my head, Lord have mercy.
Keb Mo makes it all look easy.
Day ain't even begun.
He's a master blues guitarist and singer.
Well, you know, I got a bad, bad feeling that the worst is yet to come.
He's spent decades in the public eye.
It's all right, don't worry about it, it's just a song.
And if his biography reads like one long list of accolades, well, 5 Grammy Awards will do that for a person.
Didn't get no lunch, but it did get 2 weeks' notice.
But dig a little deeper and you'll find that his music goes far beyond the blues.
There's a deeper conversation going on in every nation.
And the road to recognition was long and winding, with success by no means assured.
I had some hungry days, I had some tough times, you know. And I survived them all.
He was born Kevin Moore in Compton, California in 1951. His first musical experience was as a kid on trumpet.
Right away when I first made a sound on that trumpet, I was just like, yeah. There was some family turmoil and the trumpet ended and then stuff, school, changing schools and problems like that.
Your parents divorced when you were little?
Yeah, they divorced. So there was a lot of uprooting.
That uprooting led to some new friends and new instruments.
I learned steel drums, and I learned trap drums, I learned the congas and bongos, and the next year, I got my father and I just begged him for a guitar. I want a guitar. So he managed to scrape a little money together, and we went down to Sears and Roebuck and got me a guitar.
An acoustic Silvertone model, about $22 plus tax. So that's when he became a full-time guitar player, right? Not quite.
Then when I got to high school, I met these two guys, and they were the two French horn players in the band, the marching band. And they say, hey man, why don't you come over to us and let's talk to Mr. Thomas and see if we can get you in the band.
On what instrument?
French horn. Gave me the horn, and there I was marching in the band with a French horn.
Then came graduation and another detour, Los Angeles Technical Trade College for 2 years.
I studied architectural drafting. And for the first year, I put the guitar down. I didn't touch it for a year. And then the next year, someone called me, like they always do, why don't you come play? And that band evolved into the band that became the band that played with Papa John Creech.
Papa John Creech was a fiddler extraordinaire who'd played with everyone from Louis Armstrong to Jefferson Airplane. That's 27-year-old Keb Mo, still known as Kevin Moore, backing him on guitar. It was an invaluable musical experience.
Now I'm in this band with this guy that's playing blues, rock, and standards. So I had to play Danny Boy, I had to play Somewhere Over the Rainbow, and
but also
and
some rock. Real do-do-do-do-do.
Yup, he was even playing some pretty hard rock, but he was still waiting for his big break. He hoped it would arrive in 1980 with his first solo album, Rainmaker. Rainmaker came out shortly before Kevin turned 30, and that was significant for him.
You know, I do this record, and it was a tremendous flop. 30 was kind of like old back, you know? I thought at 30, you know, because I'm from the 60s generation, with you know, you don't trust anyone over 30, so I figured after 30, you're done. You don't make it by 30.
But Kevin Moore just kept working, and it was always a struggle.
Playing clubs, theater plays, some sessions, you know, recording sessions. You know, one time I did a TV theme for a show called, it just lasted 4 episodes. It's called Joe and Valerie.
Looking all day, looking all night. Looking for the one, looking for the one.
And that paid me $2,500, and that lasted me a couple of months.
1 year became another, and then another still, and then became a decade.
And 40 came, and then I hadn't quit yet. It was a moment when I said, I must be a musician.
So when Grammys and attention came, you were a grown-up.
Yeah, I was a grown-ass man.
He was 42 when he released his first album under his new stage moniker, Keb Mo, and so began that dazzling array of accolades. And it wasn't just Grammy Awards. In 2006, he entranced the crowd with America the Beautiful at the inauguration of the fictional president in the finale of the hit show, The West Wing.
Oh, beautiful, for spacious skies, for amber waves of green.
A decade later, he'd be invited to sing the same tune at the actual White House.
It's my great pleasure to welcome Keb Mo.
By the fruited plain, America.
But perhaps the greatest America. Honor of all is the extent to which other musicians want to perform with him. You can find him singing a lonesome Hank Williams duet with James Taylor.
A falling star.
Here he is joining Darius Rucker on a country rock tune from his new album.
You're gonna need a good strong woman that's got your back, fill you back up.
In fact, calling the role of Keb Mo's musical collaborators is nothing short of remarkable.
I started to think about who all you have played with. And if you'll forgive me.
Oh, here we go. There's a list now.
Do you mind if I read some of this list?
Not at all. Go ahead.
Amy Grant, Bela Fleck, Betty LeVette, Billy Gibbons, Bonnie Raitt, B.B. King, Bono, Cassandra Wilson, Darlene Love, Dave Holland, Dr. John.
Darlene Love, when did that happen?
Darlene Love, you're on stage with her and Elvis Costello and Bonnie Raitt and you.
Okay.
Does that sound familiar?
Yeah, okay.
Dr. John, Garth Brooks, Greg Allman, India Arie, Jackson Brown, Jimmy Vaughn, Joe Bonamassa, Joe Walsh, Gary Clark Jr., Sam Moore,
yes.
Kingfish Ingram, Kristen Chenoweth, Mavis Staples, Melissa Manchester, Old Crow Medicine Show. There's a picture of you on stage with Philip Glass.
Yeah, at the Carnegie Hall.
Angelique Kidjo, Buddy Guy, Robert Cray, Robert Randolph, Roseanne Cash, Sarah Dash, Shamika Copeland, Solomon Burke, Susan Tedeschi, Taj Mahal, Terrence Blanchard, The Muppets, Trombone Shorty, and Vince Gill. I found a picture. I was going to say you played with everybody but Donald Duck, and then I found a picture of you with Donald Duck. It's like everybody wants to play with Keb Mo, it seems.
Keb Mo's just a lucky guy. I never had a big plan in life, so to speak. But I always put one foot in front of the other and go, and I just trust the moments, you know. I have ambitions. I think ambitions and plans are two different kinds of things. You know, I have ambitions of playing music, you know, and just being able to play my whole life.
Back in the hood, who would have known that it would feel so good. Everybody
and I affectionately call my life like, it's like the Wizard of Oz. Dorothy go, how do I find this yellow brick road? He says, follow the yellow brick road. Well, where is it? You're standing on it.
This is the place.
And you were standing on it.
I was standing on the yellow brick road the whole time, my whole life.
I've been gone too long. It's good to be here. It's good to be anywhere. To be back, good to be home again. It's good to be you. It's good to be me. Good to be young. Good to be old. Good to be home again.
Good looking crowd. You